It's long time since we created a course and in 28 minutes. In this video, we want to create something which is interesting. There are a lot of times we are asked these questions. What should I learn next? Whether it's a starting programmer, a programmer with a little bit of experience, or an experienced programmer. This is the question which is always in your mind. What should I learn next? One of the things you need to understand to be able to answer that question is what's happening. What's the things which are really happening in the software world? What are the trends? That's one of the things we'll discuss at the start of this specific video. The other thing which we'll discuss is the learning roadmap that we see for Java web programmers. So if you want to develop web services or web applications with Java, then what are the kinds of learning roadmap that you are looking at? That's the second thing that we would discuss as part of this video. The last thing which we'll discuss is what are we doing at in 28 minutes in the next 2 to 3 months? There you go. Those are the three things that we would discuss in this specific video. First of all the things that we are discussing right now is in the GitHub repository, GitHub in 28 minutes, in 28 minutes course roadmap. So in 28 minutes, in 28 minutes course roadmap. You'll also find this link in the description of the video. Let's start with the first question, which is very important to understand what you should learn. The question is, what are the trends? What's happening in the industry? The first trend that we are really observing is architectures are really heading towards microservices. We are talking about web services for a long time. I mean, we talked about service-oriented architecture and things like that, and we have been using that for years together. I see a lot of talk about microservices in the last couple of years. That's the first trend we are observing. The second thing that we observe is that Spring Boot is the most popular framework now, most popular Java framework for developing microservices. Spring Boot was released in end 2014, and within 2 to 3 years, it's now the most popular framework, most popular platform to develop microservices. The other trend we see is that Spring Cloud is providing great options to develop cloud native applications. In like Netflix open source stuff is directly integrated into Spring Cloud, and it really integrates very well. I mean, I've been able to develop cloud based applications very, very easily with Spring Cloud. Those are the three important trends I have been observing. So we talked about architectures moving towards microservices, Spring Boot being the most popular frameworks for developing microservices, and Spring Cloud being a great option for developing cloud native applications. So my observation as of now, as of today, is I would say, like, if you are really wanting to be a Java web programmer, then I think you should look at getting towards all the things that you would need to learn Spring Boot. So we'll discuss more about this in specific in this video, but I think Spring Boot is your initial target if you are a starting programmer. If you are an experienced programmer, then I would kind of look at a combination. So you would need to understand microservices, a little bit of Spring Cloud. We'll talk about messaging and other stuff a little later. So if you are a starter, if you're just beginning your programming career, then what I really would recommend you is, first of all, be an expert at your language, whether it's Java, whether it's C, whatever you would want to learn, be an expert at it. The next thing that we would recommend you is to understand the basics of design. We are in the world of Agile, so there would not be a huge design documents that are prepared, or there will not be huge architecture documents that would be prepared. So we expect everyone to be independent. So we expect each of the developers to be able to design on their own. And while design, understanding completely everything about design might be a really complex thing to do, understanding the four principles of simple design, on the other hand, is not something difficult. If you go further down in this GitHub repository, you will find links to help you to learn what the four principles of simple design are. So I would recommend you to understand what the four principles of simple design and try and apply them. The third thing we recommend is to be good at your IDE, whether you're using NetBeans or IntelliJ or Eclipse. Be an expert at that. You would be using this tool for a long time, so you better be an expert at that. The other thing which we recommend is to understand your build tool. You're not going to just use Java to develop your application, right? So you'd be using a lot of frameworks. You'd want to be able to pull them in, and you'd want to be able to create projects which are easily reproducible. So Maven is really a great tool towards that. I mean, Maven, Gradle, whichever one you prefer, understand your build tool. So when you start off, these are the things I recommend you to start off with. The understanding JSP servlets is a great thing because you'd want to understand the basics of developing web applications. So even though you can directly start with Spring MVC or Spring Boot, I don't really recommend that. I would really love you to understand the JSP servlets. I mean, it's great to begin with it, develop one application, simple web application with it, to understand what it's all about. And then build an application with Spring MVC, or you can even use Struts if you would want to. But I recommend Spring MVC on top of Struts because Spring is kind of the in thing, for the last decade or so. And then we recommend you to understand Spring and Spring Boot in depth. So Spring is a dependency injection framework. So you need to understand the concept of dependency injection and understand Spring in that context. And the next thing is you need to understand how Spring Boot makes it easy. So this is kind of the learning roadmap we are looking at. And then you can move on to building REST services using Spring MVC, or it might even be JaxRS if you're interested in that. And one of the things that we also see is that Java developers are kind of expected to have a little bit of knowledge on the front end as well. So try and get a little bit of familiarity with any of the front end frameworks. AngularJS or React would not hinder you at all. So if you are an aspiration web programmer, these are the things I really recommend you to focus on at the start. I mean, these are a lot of things. I think the most complex thing in this path which we are talking about is learning the language. So because the programming is something which is really difficult to pick up at the start. So once you are good at your language, I think rest of the stuff is you can learn them pretty quickly. So if I think like to be an expert at your language probably takes a decade or so. But to get started with a language, I think 2 to 3 months or 1 or 2 to 3 months of practice with the language should be sufficient. And basics of design, again, this is a very complex topic. You don't really want to, I won't say you'd become an expert at design very quickly. So you can get started with design, I would say that. But if you want to understand Eclipse, Maven, building one application with JSP servlets, one with Spring MVC and Spring Boot, I don't think this would take a long time. Once you have an expertise with the language, I think if with good help, good training, good coaching available, I think you can cover this stuff in a month. Understanding the concept of REST services is a little more difficult, so you might want a little more time down there. So is getting front-end framework. So, I mean, the objective was for you to understand what are the different things that are involved. What are the things that I think a programmer who's coming into my project, what are the things I would expect them to know? So those are the things that are important. And if you're an experienced programmer, let's say you have a lot of experience already and you're looking at and you already understand all this stuff, I would expect any experienced programmer to at least have a little bit of familiarity with all the things which we discussed earlier. If you really want to move further ahead, I would really want you to understand microservices architecture. Think about AWS. Try and understand what Amazon Web Services do. Try and understand what Spring Cloud does. What are the different projects that are under Spring Cloud umbrella? Try and understand the rest of the topics are kind of things you need to pick up based on your interest. I wouldn't really expect anyone to be an expert at all these topics at the same time. But in these topics, I would really expect you to pick up something which you are interested in. One of the trending topics is big data and analytics. Hadoop is one of the famous, most popular platforms, if I can call it so. The other thing I would really recommend is we are moving towards event-driven architectures. With microservices, the focus is on creating event-driven architectures, message-based programming. So it's great if you can understand messaging. I mean, we are used to messaging with big buses like the enterprise service bus and things like that. But now we are going more towards simpler things. Like if you can use Kafka or AMQP or JMS. So try and understand what these are, what are the different things which are happening in the messaging world. what are the problems with JMS, why AMQP came in, and how Kafka solves the problem of scaling with messaging. These are the things we would recommend you to learn next. Try and understand functional and reactive programming. Like, functional programming is one of the new concepts in, it's no longer new. I mean, it's Java 8 has been there for quite a while right now. So understanding functional programming is an important thing. Reactive programming is another interesting thing. I mean, it's one of the features in Java 9, and Spring Reactor framework also has good amount of reactive features in there. And there's a framework called Spring Web Flux, which is coming out with Spring 5, which has a lot of content on reactive programming. So yeah, try and look at them. Understanding continuous integration, delivery, and DevOps, I think this is a continuous thing. So this is something which I would expect all the experienced developers to know. And understanding containerization, it is also something which you can focus on if you are interested in that specific area. What we did until now is just looked at the high-level trends of what I recommend you to focus on to learn. This is May 2017, and these are my views as of today. The next thing we wanted to talk about is the learning roadmap we think is the right way to approach things at in 28 minutes. So we start with the basics, where we would talk about the language itself, the IDE, build tool. Unit testing is one more important thing, and like simple design with refactoring. At level two are kind of the frameworks, if you allow me to call them that way. So Spring, understanding JSP servlets, like your basics of MVC, and also Hibernate and Mockito for mocking. At level two, we would put web services, like developing them with Spring Boot, using things like JHipster to create your projects, and using Spring Cloud. I would say Spring Cloud is even more complex, probably a level three. And then you can focus on your front end stuff. In the others, we talk about a lot of things which apply to all these levels. So we'll look at each one of these in detail. As of the basics, I would expect you to be an expert at the language you're using. You should be an expert. I mean, there's no exception to that. So for C, we have courses which help you to learn C. So we have a C tutorial for beginners, and we have a course on C puzzles as well. So I'm sure you'll find them interesting. Java is the language you'd want to learn. I mean, we don't really have a great deal of good content on Java at this point. The only course that we have on Java is Oops Advanced. It's more for programmers who have already good experience with Java. If they want to understand the advanced concepts in Oops, that's the course we created in Udemy. It's actually doing really well. You should be an expert at your IDE. So we have created about 2-hour course on Eclipse, which helps you to become an expert at Eclipse. And the other thing which we would love you to do is to understand your build tool, Maven. Maven offers a lot of features which makes you productive. I mean, you'd be able to be productive at your current project as well as productive while creating and setting up new projects. And we have a great course on Udemy on Maven as well. So JUnit, unit testing is a very, very important topic that we would want you to learn. So we have a course on JUnit, which is linked down here. And test-driven development is something I would really love everybody to follow. Like, there are practical difficulties in following TDD in a lot of projects, but there's no I would expect you to just get started with it, try and understand what it is and things like that. We don't really have anything great on refactoring right now. I would hope there would be something in here a little later, not in our near-term plans, but maybe in future. Simple design, 4 principles of simple design. This is a great set of 4 videos which would introduce you to 4 principles of simple design. At level one, we would put Spring, and there's a good course, like Spring framework tutorial for beginners. We would work on a new version of this course a little later this year, probably. But this is a good beginning. I wouldn't say it's a very good course or something, but it's not a bad start. Let's put it that way. JSP Servlet, this is an awesome course. I mean, this is something which a lot of starting programmers who are developing with their first web application love. I mean, I have awesome reviews on this specific course on Udemy. I mean, this is, I think, the best possible way for you to start learning developing web applications with Java. So JSP Servlets and this is an awesome course. And Spring MVC, this is the most popular course that we have on Udemy completely. I mean, this is really the best-selling course on Spring MVC on Udemy right now, May 2017. And it has awesome reviews. I mean, you would not believe the kind of reviews that we are getting for this course. What you're seeing on the screen is one of these reviews I've read just today morning. It says the best programming course, online course I've ever subscribed to. I love the course Spring MVC for beginners. I mean, it was a lot of effort to create that course, but I mean, it is getting the results. It has great love from the students. We want to create a course on Hibernate, maybe like 3 to 6 months timeline I'm thinking about. Mockito is one of the best courses I've created as well. So this course gives you a great introduction to mocking, why you need mocking, how mocking makes unit testing very easy, and what are the situations. I mean, it also talks about how you can test private methods and static methods and things like that. The level two, we talk about Spring Boot, and in Spring Boot, we have a really, really good course. I mean, Spring Boot Tutorial for Beginners. This is a course which this is the latest course that we have created, and it has good reviews, and it covers all the features of Spring Boot, including auto configuration, startup projects, actuator, whatever you talk about Spring Boot, it's covered down here. We don't really have a lot of stuff at the level two right now, but I'm sure within the next 3 months, these two courses would be created. We are creating courses on web services. Web services and Java are really our focus areas for the next 3 months. So we would want to be able to create courses on Java. So we would want to help you get started in Java the best possible way. And we would also want to help you to learn web services in the best possible way. So those are the two gaps which we would want to really focus on, and we would want to fill in the next 3 months. JHipster is a nice thing to learn. And Spring Cloud is something probably we are looking at like a 3 to 6 months timeline, I would say. Next set of courses, maybe. I don't think frontend is a focus area of us right now. Probably 6 to 12 month timeline is where we would see the courses on frontend. And we have other courses on interviews, Java interview. It's a very good course, I would say. So if you are trying to prepare for a Java interview, you'd want to recollect all the stuff that you have learned over a period of time, then this is a perfect course for that. And we have a Git repository for best practices. The Java EE architecture framework and patterns is a nice course if you are new to Java and new to web application development. You have just developed your first web application. You want to understand all the different patterns, frameworks which are there. What are the architecture, what's the different things about architecture that you need to be interested on? This is an awesome course. I mean, I would really want to expand this course in a while to include microservices also. But for now, it does a good job at covering up an MVC kind of an architecture with Java web applications. Microservices is something which you'd want to focus on and build. We have a really good course on design patterns. This is a free course. You can try that out. And the other area which we want to expand in, that's the third focus area for us. First one was Java. The second one was web services. The third one which we wanted to focus on a lot more is automation testing with Selenium. I think that's a very interesting area. That's an area where we wanted to create courses on. The last but not the least, which is always in our radar, but it keeps skipping us somehow or the other, is code quality. We would want to really focus on code quality and create programs around that, but probably in the future. Okay, there you go. So we covered what are the trends and what is the learning roadmap we are looking at. I mean, we also talked about what are the things that we are planning to do in 28 minutes in the next 3 months. I hope to be able to create this kind of a video every few months so that I give a roadmap of what are the trends in the industry as well as how we are adapting our learning roadmap for it. If you have any feedback on any of the things that we have discussed as part of this video, do leave us a comment. We really value your suggestions, and I'm sure whatever suggestions which you would give us would be incorporated into our learning. Until the next time, here's bye from Ranga Karnam at In 28 Minutes. See you. Bye-bye.